Are you ready, yo?
Like your radio, we need you to tune in.
I'm going to tell you how I honestly got there. He used to date this girl, and I don't talk about this. He used to date this girl that he really was crazy about.
Mm-hmm.
And she got on drugs.
Yeah. Okay.
And he was like, he helped her. He stood after her. He fought for her.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, well, maybe if I take a little bit, so maybe he'll
fight for me. Right,
me.
Right.
And that's how I landed in that world.
Stand up and I'm searching for the better part of me. Yeah, 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 yeah. I hang my head from...
Me and my brother was close, and my sister, we was close. Me and my brother was real close at one point in my life, and I remember used to have to fight for them and take up for them in different situations. But then things changed a little bit. My brother was the only boy. He was spoiled by my mama, just spoiled. And it seemed like he took all of her attention. And I remember him getting on drugs at an early age and different things was going on. And then that's when the part came in where, like, felt like I wasn't loved anymore. It felt like that I had to go above and beyond to get the attention that I desired from my mother. My father was always there, got attention from him. But it was that mother's love that I felt like I needed more of and I was missing. Her and my sister, my mother and my sister was very close. But I just didn't have that part. But when I think about it, you know, she died from dementia, and I think about that, how I missed out on some things. What could I have done differently to salvage that relationship, to make it better, to make it better? What I could have done differently to make my brother's relationship better before he passed away? My mother died a few years ago from dementia, and I always thought that before she passed that we would bring that gap together,
mm-hmm.
and it would be fixed.
Wow.
It wasn't fixed the way I wanted it to be fixed, but mm-hmm. it was fixed. I think about my brother more and I think about my mom, and people will say, well, that's wrong and that's bad or whatever, but that's just my life.
Now,
that's
do you think it's because of the closure that you may have had with your brother that maybe you did not have with your mother?
Maybe.
Mm-hmm.
I don't understand it,
mm-hmm.
but maybe.
Mm-hmm.
It may be that.
I hang my head from sorrow.
I had my daughter when I was 17,
okay.
teenage pregnancy, and
mm-hmm.
looking for love in all the wrong places, but
mm-hmm.
found love when I had Shannon. Having her taught me how to really love, to give what I was looking for.
Mm-hmm.
I was looking for that love from my parents, and that, you know, that, like that
bond.
White picket fence thing, you know, that thing you do. But I didn't really, I felt it from my father, but I didn't really feel it from my mother like I wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
And so, when my daughter came, I would love her
mm-hmm.
the way I wanted to be loved.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I treated my children, you know, I had to learn how to not give them what I got at home.
Mm-hmm.
The fussing and the cussing and all that kind of
right.
stuff. But let me tell you, I did start off that way.
Okay.
Fussing
okay.
and cussing because that's what
that's
I
what
knew.
You did. Yeah.
So I had to kind of, you know, find my way into being the mother that I wanted to be. Like I said, I love my daughter,
mm-hmm.
but looking for that love from that male
mm-hmm.
figure. So
mm-hmm.
I'm going to tell you how I honestly got there. He used to date this girl. And I don't talk about this. He used to date this girl that he really was crazy about.
Mm-hmm.
And she got on drugs.
Okay.
And he was like, he helped her. He stood after her. He fought for her.
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, well, maybe if I take a little bit of something, maybe he'll
fight for me.
And
right,
help me.
Right.
And that's how I landed in that world.
Okay.
Some of the struggles of being in that lifestyle and that world out there with them drugs and all that, and being in that relationship with him at that time, very abusive, name-calling, fighting, always, you know, nothing for me to come home and be somebody else at my home that shouldn't have been there, if you understand what I'm saying. Just a mess. Police banging on the door, kicking the door, and just a lifestyle that was not pleasing. And I'm gonna tell you one thing, I'm glad I made it out of it. I'm glad that I did not die in that lifestyle. I'm glad I made it out of that lifestyle with my mind clear and able to move on in life, to see life in a different view, because that's not where I was supposed to be, and that's not where I want to ever be, and that's not where I would ever desire for anybody else to be. You know, it's different. It's a different kind of world. And it's, I can say it's not good. It's not
but
good.
But yeah, I kept functioning. I kept going to work. My husband was an ex-drug dealer. So my ex-husband was an ex-drug dealer. And that's how I was getting my supplies and stuff like that. So,
Wow.
It was wild, too.
Yes. Like, yes. Now, how your children, did they ever see you out of character, out of self?
Well, Shannon stayed with my mom. Mm-hmm. Mikey was with me. He would be on the floor beside me. I'd be getting high.
Really?
It's just, you know, that's just how it was.
Right.
You know, it got high a few times before he came into the world. He was in my stomach. That's just how it was.
Wow.
You know, but I thank God that he delivered him to be a smart and healthy, brilliant baby. Mm-hmm. And to this day, he's still brilliant. He's a brilliant young man. Mm-hmm. So, you know, he wasn't affected by it. Mm-hmm. You know, I wanted to stop, right? Mm-hmm. So I didn't know how to. So I went to Glass Treatment Center of America, Glass Mental Health of America. I can't remember what it was. Mm-hmm. But they told me that they wouldn't admit me because I never tried to kill myself. So I was like, what? Like, I didn't understand it. So right. Glass Mental Health. And so I went home and I contemplated cutting my wrist. I'm like, okay, so, because I wanted to get help. I used to work the night shift at the post office, and I went to the EAP counselor.
Mm-hmm.
And he got me to a treatment center down on Poplar Street at the time. Mm-hmm. But I never stopped functioning. I kept going to work every day. I went to work. My mother didn't know. Mm-hmm. And when it was time for me to go, I called the man at work and I said, I don't have nobody, because I had my daughter and my son. I said, I don't have nobody to watch my kids. I had Mikey by that time,
mm-hmm.
and Shannon. I said, I don't have nobody to watch my kids.
Mm-hmm.
And I said, could you call my mother and ask her, would she watch my kids mm-hmm. for me? And he called, and I stayed at the top of the steps, and I could hear downstairs she was crying, and she said, yes, I'll watch them.
I found love through Jesus Christ. You know, I got saved and I took my children with me to church, and I've never looked back. I found that he drew me to him. And I'm talking about Jesus, a man, this love that's so real and so unconditional and so undeserving, but he just gives it to you and it fills every void and everything that you're going through in life. I've been called to the ministry of the preaching the gospel of Jesus Christ. Wow. Like, that's really something. Like, I'm just amazed, and not at myself, but at how God has used me. Because I know that is not me within myself, that God has called me. And to see where he has brought me from all the trials and tribulations that I went through in my life, to stand in a pulpit and to be able to deliver a word to his people for lives to be changed for the better, when I was just like somebody so lost out there. And to be used is a great feeling. And to see yourself and you just sit back there and say, oh my God. Like, it's a humbling experience. It's humbling. It's life changing. It makes you be in awe of God, because who would have thought? I'd have never thought in all my life and in all my living that I'd be wind up doing something like that. Life, I can say, is great. Life, I can also say, has its challenges. Life is to be lived now, not tomorrow, not later, but life is to be lived now. Live in the fullness of your life and give it all that you have. Because who knows when this time is over? Who knows when you will take your last breath? You don't ever want to live. I know I don't want to leave here on full. I want to be empty. I want to be able to pull out everything that's inside of me for the world to get a glimpse inside of the world of Linda King Tribble. That's what I want. Superwoman, yes I